giant trees that live in the coastal redwood forest get a lot of attention. But what most people don't know about is the equally as cool animals that call this place their home.
Oh, shoot.
Today, I'm going to hunt down a few of these elusive creatures.
Oh, slender salamander.
So I think we finally found the culprit.
Lane Wilson.
Since 95% of the original giant redwood forest have been cut down throughout the 1900s, this environment is very rare and unique, being the only place in the entire world like it. In the remaining old growth forests, they're one of the most pristine and healthy environments I have ever been to. There's many kinds of animals that have died out in other parts of California that still thrive in the redwood forest. On the other hand, finding these animals can still be pretty tricky.
I think we found something.
If I am correct, I believe this is a California slender salamander.
The first find of the day. These are the most common salamander in California, which isn't surprising because I would end up finding quite a few more of these little guys throughout the day.
Another slender newt.
One really interesting thing about these short-legged ambush predators is they'll typically stay within no larger than a 6-foot by 6-foot area their entire lives. They'll settle down under a nice rotted out log where they'll lie in wait for their favorite snacks to come in and greet them. Those unlucky house guests are usually small insects like these guys. The first few times I saw a California slender salamander, I confused them as either a worm or a small snake, which is easy to see why with their pretty unique shape that they have. The next animal I set out to find was the very colorful California redleg frog. These are one of my favorite amphibians that can be found in California, but sometimes they can be pretty difficult to hunt down. In past trips to the redwoods, I was lucky enough to come across some of these rare frogs. I hoped this time I'd be able to find them again.
Man, those frogs are really good at getting away.
I had been searching around this trail for almost the entire day at this point, and I only found one redleg frog. So I hiked out and went to the nearest source of Wi-Fi to research an area that had more sightings. And it was definitely a good decision, because within 10 minutes of being on the new trail, we saw one. I had finally caught a California redleg frog. These frogs have died out in 70% of their historic range throughout California. This unfortunately makes them a threatened species. They're actually the largest frog in the western United States, only a little bit smaller than the non-native American bullfrog, which outcompetes and even eats redleg frogs. In areas where they are still found, like in the giant redwood forest, they're usually found hopping around streams and ponds with their powerful back legs. where they themselves will hunt for pretty much anything that fits in their mouths. And once again, I was back on the hunt.
See all these little gnats right here? This is exactly what the frogs are going to be eating, so.
My next place to look was near an old logging pool. This new area was the perfect environment for what I'd hoped I'd find next. I was looking for a rarely sighted California giant salamander, which can grow up to 12 inches long.
Got one.
It's a bright green tree frog.
Oh wow.
Look how bright green that is.
I unfortunately didn't find the salamander like I had hoped I would, but I did end up finding a few much more common Pacific tree frogs. While they are more common and found in places other than the redwood forest, they're still very cool animals. These frogs can change their color depending on the season to better blend into their environment. I've personally seen them be green and brown, but I've heard sometimes they can be even red or black. I ended up following a stream that ran off the logging pool to continue the search for the California giant salamander.
Oh, shoot.
The environment around me started to change quite a bit as I followed it. Initially, the trees that were surrounding me were large redwoods, but they began to get smaller as I went further. I followed the stream for quite a while, and eventually, I ended up in a large sandy plain that led all the way to the ocean. Once again, I didn't find the giant salamander on this little detour to the ocean, but it was really cool to see how close the source of the dense fog that waters this forest is. As I was hiking back from the ocean, I started noticing something strange.
Slime. Looks like more slime. Where is it? Oh, there. There's the slime.
Got another thing of slime.
This is a big one.
A little bit of slime. Interesting.
What it is, I have no idea. But I am seeing a lot of it. Never seen this before. Every single time I've been here.
The spittlebug adds some chemicals and then mixes in air. The result is a foamy substance known as cuckoo spit, which spittlebugs use to envelop themselves in a protective bubbly cocoon that actually looks like spit, but is more like pee. And it doesn't have anything to do with...
Interesting. So it came from these little bugs that drink sap from the stems of plants with these little mosquito fang things. And then they pee out like the excess because it's just a lot of it. And that means I was basically touching plant vampire pee? Nice.
The chances of me finding a giant salamander were beginning to go down as I was nearing my end of my time in the redwoods. But at this point, I hadn't given up hope that I would find one. As I was walking down the trail, I saw some tiny western toads jumping in the grass next to me. I wasn't able to get a recording of me trying to catch them in time, but here's the one that I did end up catching. They all seem to be pretty young because western toads can grow up to 5 inches. I had to be aware when handling this guy because western toads can release a toxin through their skin to deter predators. But for the most part, they're fine to touch just as long as you wash your hands afterwards. And don't eat them. I definitely recommend not eating them.
Alright, I'm gonna put him back where I found him.
All right, so I'm on a bit of a time constraint right now, so gonna have to start heading back. Might find some other stuff on the way back, but otherwise, we'll be back at night to see if we can find anything out here, like salamanders and newts and stuff, because I've heard that they're most active at night, so let's see if that's true. All right, back on the same trail we were on before. Hopefully we can find something out here. Don't want to stay out here too long. It's getting pretty cold already, but yeah, let's go do it. Now this really was my last chance to find the elusive California giant salamander. While I didn't have much time left, the climate was on my side. The giant salamander is mainly spotted when it's night. They're most active at night because the wet, cool air keeps its skin from drying out. If I was lucky enough, I hoped I might just find one. All right, we probably gotta get going. So I guess I was not lucky enough. After about 6 hours of searching, I found one banana slug and absolutely no giant salamanders. So I guess I'm gonna have to go back and find one. If you wanna see that video when it comes out, make sure to click on this little picture of my face right here. Until then,